Now, let us try to find out electric field near an infinitely long charged wire. Now, we will take a set of charges which are distributed over a line, or you take a very fine wire which is charged. Charges are distributed over a length. How do you find out the electric field? We have seen how to find out the electric field due to a point charge using Coulomb's inverse square law. We have found how to find out the electric field due to a spherical conductor using Gauss law. Now it is an infinitely long wire. Of course, we have to use the Gauss law only. Now, suppose you have a very long wire. I will show it using dotted lines like this and charged positively. Select a point here at a distance r and place a test charge here in order to find out the electric field. How will be the electric field? Now, you divide this wire into a number of pieces like this. Small pieces, taking that all the charges in those pieces as a single charge. All the charges here from this piece will repel it like this. All the charges from this piece will repel the test charge like this, because I have kept a test charge here. All the charges in this piece will repel it like this. All the charges in this piece will repel it like this, because this is infinitely long. And okay, it should be like this. Now, and all the charges here vertically in front of it will repel it like this. What is the result of this finally? So here also there are positive charges. They will also repel it like this, like this. What is the resultant of this? Now, for every electric field here, you will get an electric field here. Now, if this is horizontal line, you take the component like this. Take the component of this in this direction. That is E sine theta. And this is E cos theta. Similarly, component of this E electric field here. So this is also theta. Component of this is E cos theta. And E sine theta here component, and E cos theta, and you will find that all these vertical components cancel. You can take an electric field here, and you can get the component here also, and you can take an here electric field, here component, but all these components come in the same direction, they add up. What about the components in the vertical direction? They cancel. So finally, the result is electric field only radially outward like this. Suppose you have a tube light. Kept like this, you know that no light travels like this from the tube light, from the sides. All the light will travel like this, like this, like this, only vertically from this curved surface. Like this, like this, like this, like this. So, tube light emits light only in these directions. No light comes from the top and bottom. So, finally, even if you select a point here and keep a test charge, its direction of electric field is like this. So from an infinitely long wire, electric field lines are radially out. They are never like this. You won't get an electric field like this. They are like this. Even if there are electric field lines here like this, their components, vertical components cancel, horizontal components add up, only this will remain. Of course, these horizontal components adding up, vertical components cancelling, we have seen it in problems, dipoles and all. Same concept applies here. So, because of an infinitely long charged wire or linearly distributed charge, electric field lines are radially out. Here it is radially out. Here it is radially out. This positive charge should be repelled directly like this. This is infinitely long. We will use this concept now, right? Now, if you want to apply Gauss law, you have to place this charged body inside a enclosure. In order to apply Gauss law, we should have an enclosure, a Gaussian surface. Sir, where we will place it, sir? Which is the suitable one? Of course, the flux through any closed surface does not depend on the size and shape of the surface. You can choose any shape. But which is most convenient for us so that our derivation is very easy? Sir, shall we keep this charged wire? Shall I keep this charged wire plus infinitely long like this? Shall I keep it inside a sphere? No, this is not the best choice, because for all these charges, surface is nearer. For these charges, surface is nearer. For these charges, surface is far away. For these charges, surface is very close. It is not equally distributed. If it was a point, if it was a spherical conductor, I would have used a sphere. For a wire, this is not the best choice. Sir, shall I use a pyramid like this? Whether this is the best choice and keep the charged wire inside? No, again the surfaces are not in the same distance. best choice is the cylinder. Of course, it might have entered into your brain that cylinder is the best choice. If you take a charged wire, cylinder is the best choice to enclose it. Of course, since this is infinitely long, you can't have an infinitely long cylinder, but only a part of the wire we will take. Now, electric field lines due to this charged wire are radially out like this. So, they are moving normally out of the curved part of the cylinder. So, that is what the introduction needed. If you have followed this, we will solve the or derive the equation. Electric field due to infinitely long straight wire. So, I will take an infinitely long straight wire like this. But I will consider only one part of the wire. Of course, if I take one part of the wire, it is enough. I will take L length of the wire, only L length, this much of the wire. And it is charged everywhere positively, and the charges are distributed equally along the length. And let the charge within this length be Q. So, charge distributed over this length be Q. Only from here to here, I am saying. Total charge may be different because it is infinitely long. So, how do you write the linear charge distribution or linear charge density lambda is equal to charge distributed per unit length Q by L. That implies Q is equal to lambda L. So, we did the same process even in finding the electric field due to a spherical conductor, spherical shell. There we have used surface charge density. Here we have to use linear charge density, lambda. Lambda is equal to charge per unit length. Q is equal to lambda L. Now, if you want to find out the electric field at any point from the charge, say I will select a point here, which is at a distance r from the charged wire. I want to find out the electric field here. You know that the electric field is radially out. So, enclose this wire in a Gaussian surface. That is, cylinder is the best choice. I will imagine a cylinder at a distance r, and the base of the cylinder is here, lid of the cylinder is here, and this is the point where, okay, I want to find out the electric field, and the cylinder is having a radius r because distance is r, and you can see it here. Q is the charge over this wire, over only this much of length. Of course, if you take the extra length, of course, it doesn't count. You will find that finally this L will be removed from the equation. Now, imagine a small area here of area delta S. Now, how are the electric field lines passing through this area? Normally out. Where is the normal to this surface area? It is also normal, is also along this direction. So, this is normal and these are the electric field lines. And these electric field lines are normally coming out, radially symmetrical, we have seen it. Okay. Now, so theta is 0 here, cos theta is 1, cos 0, 1. Because theta is the angle between electric field lines and the normal, E delta is cos theta. So, what is the flux through this small area? Flux through this small area, delta phi is equal to E delta S cos 0. So, flux through the small area is E delta S. Now, what is the flux through the entire Gaussian surface? You have to consider such areas here, 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 everywhere. So, you have to cover the full cylindrical body. Whereas, you need not worry about the flux through these two areas. Sir, why? Is there any flux through this? Remember, all the flux is passing like this. No flux is passing like this. So, you need not worry about that part. No flux is passing like this. Suppose you have a tube light like this. All the light is passing like this through the body of the cylinder. No light is passing from this side. So, no light passes through this lid and the bottom part of the cylinder. So, you need not worry about those two regions. Flux through the entire this surface is given by phi is equal to the summation of delta phi, which is nothing but summation of E delta S. So, what is the flux through the entire cylindrical body? Flux through the entire cylindrical body is, so E can be taken out because electric field due to this wire here, here, here are same, they are at equal distances. Now you might have understood why did we select the cylinder, not the sphere, because equal distances, electric field can be taken outside the summation sigma delta S. So what is flux through the entire Gaussian surface? E into what is sigma delta S? It is the surface area of the cylinder. Now the circumference of one circle is E into 2 pi r, this one, such 2 pi r's over a length L into L. That is the surface area. Surface area of a cylinder, 2 pi r L. I am not talking about the volume of the cylinder. Volume of the cylinder is pi r squared into h. Now it is 2 pi r L. So this is second equation. First equation. Electric field, flux due to the entire Gaussian surface using our small formula. Now what does Gauss theorem say? Gauss theorem says that the flux through the entire cylinder, it is 1 by epsilon naught times the total charge enclosed within the cylinder. Right? The flux through the entire cylinder is Gaussian surface is 1 by epsilon naught times the total charge. But we know that total charge is Q equal to lambda L, the linear charge density lambda is equal to charge per unit length, and Q is equal to lambda L into L. So substitute for Q. Flux through the entire Gaussian surface, 1 by epsilon naught, Q lambda L. Equation 2. Compare the two equations. They say the same thing. Flux through the entire Gaussian surface, flux through the entire Gaussian surface. So right hand side must be equal. 2 pi RL, E into 2 pi RL must be equal to lambda L by epsilon naught, this expression and this one. LL gets cancelled. What is E? That implies E is equal to, because our aim is to find out electric field due to this wire here. So E is equal to, this is lambda divided by 2 pi epsilon naught R. See, finally, L didn't come into picture. What length you have taken for the wire, even if it is infinitely long, what length you have considered, which is containing charge Q, it didn't come into picture because it doesn't depend on that. Because if you have taken longer length, you would have got more lambda, more Q, that gives the same lambda. So more the length you take, more will be the Q, so lambda is a constant. So lambda comes into picture, how much it is charged per unit length. And if you want to write in a vector form, put a r cap here, where r cap is a unit vector in the direction of electric field. This may be the direction of electric field here. And so this is the formula you have to derive. Electric field due to a long, straight, infinitely long straight wire, charged uniformly. So this is one. Thank you.